Vital part of creating solution architecture is the selection of technologies for each of the components. When selecting a technology stack, you should look at from architectural and development perspective as well. One of the oddest things about technology selection is that for every problem, there are several technology options and a lot of information available about them. Fortunately, selecting right technology stack is not that tricky, and you can quickly trim the options down with considering some of the key factors that we are going to see in this video. Let's see what those are. The first key factor we are going to see is getting a high level understanding of current reference architecture will help you to understand the patterns, tools, framework, and technology already comfortable in your domain. This would support your decision and narrow down to your right selection as well. Some of the key examples are SSO model, file transferring, content management, messaging queue, and so. The next factor to be considered is, in addition to reference architecture, generally, there should be a preferred technology or a strategic dev and testing platform in enterprise-wide. Java and C# are the commonly used programming languages for large or complex projects in the enterprises. Oracle for better scalability of large size data source, Selenium framework for automation testing suite are some of the examples. Thus, you can get some idea of applicability of a technology that you consider selecting. This factor is more about finding the landscape of tools in your industry. The technology you pick should power your application development. Capitalizing on existing industry tools and components instead of developing on your own will dramatically reduce the overall development effort and time to market. It could be a COTS product or open source framework or even a SaaS subscription. But do remember, a larger community of developers' contribution and support of technical forums are necessary to foster development. For example, .NET and Java, both languages having a vast talent pool and extensive product documentation. Next factor is, your enterprise may continue hosting on-premises servers or already being in adoption of cloud platforms or may be under planning in near future. However, your tech choice should consider the target platform compatibility as well. For example, if you have a requirement to build a long-running background process, then .NET Core Worker Services should be a right fit over a traditional .NET Windows services. So taking the target hosting platform into consideration is a vital step in selecting the technology layers. Next in our list is deciding technology based on application roadmap. Your selection should be futuristic option. For example, if you are developing a new application that has a longer domain or business scope to evolve further, then .NET Core is a right choice over traditional .NET framework for high performance and scalable systems. Sometimes it may be other way around. You may need a component only till end of the certain period, let's say phase 1 execution, and later which may be rebuilt or fully replaced with something else. So bringing a new technology may not be a best bet considering its incurrence cost, which will become a regret spending later. Another critical factor is, your technology selection should support to develop a secure application. Generally, banking or health applications must comply with certain security standards like HIPAA. So your selection should be able to meet those standards. For example, fintech platforms are usually built using Java or .NET because of regulatory and compliance issues. The next thing is, the technology you select should solve your solution requirements efficiently. Some examples like, if you have a requirement to build responsive pages or multi-browser support, then the CSS framework you selected and its elements should be compatible with that. Or some solution constraints like supporting underlying legacy components of current state, that is connecting to an older version of database or hosting on prior version of Windows operating system, etc. So keep your problem spaces in your mind while selecting a technology. Next factor is about software licensing, which could directly influence your development cost. Leveraging existing enterprise license will help saving development and distribution licensing cost. Simply following a trending technology and obtaining a new licensing may not be a cost-effective decision in the longer run. Another critical, perhaps the most important, is defining the non-functional aspects of solution before you select a technology. Realization of NFR like scalability, performance, cross-platform support, seamless integration capacity or documentation, etc. will definitely help you to find the right fit. Let's say when number of users goes up, the app must be able to handle the load and accommodate the future growth, so the framework you select should have excellent scalability support like the components of the main stack, that is Angular and Node.js. Similarly, gRPC service is well known for super fast performance, and supporting the SSL TDE encryption are essential for better data security. So do remember, the technology you select should give full control over supporting all the NFRs that applies to your solution. Resource skill set plays a vital role in choosing technology. When choosing a technology, make sure there are enough developers in the market or in your team with the skills you require. Let's say there are two different frameworks, both could meet your needs. For example, Angular and React.js. Then you should prefer the one in which your team does have strong expertise. Otherwise, you would end up in spending time and cost for developing new skills as learning curve. The next factor to be considered is, it is better to go with proven technologies rather reinvent the wheel unless it is critical to your solution. Because the technology is a tool that can help you to build a profitable business. At end of the day, your users will not care how trendy is your technology stack, but they will care how well your application or system works. Finally, performing a POC is essential to quickly validate your selection. The scope may be a piece of technology work or MVP of business requirements, but its outcome would help you to make a concrete decision for rest of the execution. Do remember, the technology recommendation should be specific to your project or solution requirements, rather a high-level proposal like a Gartner report. That's all for now. I hope this video helped you to learn how to make a more informed decision on selecting a technology that fit for your solution requirements. As a final note, every technology has its own pros and cons. Only you can determine which solution is best given your requirements. So you should do a detailed technical selection analysis before finalizing it with considering these factors. Thanks for watching. If you find this video is helpful, please like this video and share your comments.